So let us see this problem on inverse Fourier transform, finding inverse Fourier transform. Using partial fraction method, find the inverse Fourier transform of, so there are four questions given, 1, 2, 3, 4. You want to find out inverse Fourier transform of these signals by using partial fraction method. So very simple question. So for this, so remember these formulas, when we do partial fraction methods, e power minus at into u of t is Fourier transform. So what is the answer? Simple answer, 1 by j omega plus a. So this formula is very very important. Now t into e power minus at into u of t, this problem also we have done earlier. So what is the answer? 1 by j omega plus a whole square. I use these two formulas in the inverse Fourier transforms using partial fraction method. So now let us do the first problem. What is the first problem? So x of omega is equal to j 5 omega plus 12 by, so j omega whole square plus 5 into j omega plus 6. So first of all, what we will do is that, so what we will do is that j 5 omega plus 12 by, so separate this denominator like this. So as fractions, j omega plus 2 into j omega plus 3. You can check that j omega whole square, 2 j omega plus 3 j omega, 5 j omega and 6. So therefore, what is partial fraction method? You can write it as a by, so j omega plus 2 plus b by j omega plus 3. So use shortcut method to find out a and b values. Remember that while finding a, so what is the denominator of a? J omega plus 2. Multiply with j omega plus 2. J omega plus 2, j omega plus 2 get cancelled out. So therefore, j 5 omega plus 12 by j omega plus 3. In this answer, substitute j omega is equal to minus 2. So this is what the shortcut method. When finding the value of a, just multiply this function with the denominator of a, and in the answer substitute j omega is equal to minus 2. So therefore, j omega is equal to minus 2. If you substitute minus 2 here, so 5 into minus 2 minus 10, 12 minus 10 is 2 by 3 minus 2 will become 1, so it is 2. Similarly, what is how to find out the value of b? So what is the denominator of b? J omega plus 3, multiply with j omega plus 3, so it will become j 5 omega plus 12 by j omega plus 2. So what we have to substitute? We have substitute j omega is equal to minus 3. So what we get? Minus 3. So minus 15 plus 12, so it will become minus 3 by, so minus 3 plus 2 minus 1, so it will become 3. So therefore, x of omega can be written as a. What is a? 2 by j omega plus 2. So what is b? 3 by j omega plus 3. So now, so taking inverse Fourier transform on both sides, taking inverse Fourier transform on both sides. So what you get taking inverse Fourier transform of both sides? X of omega will become x of t. So that is equal to 2 into, I have given the formula for e power minus a is 2, a 2t into u of t plus, what is this, is written as inverse Fourier transform of 1 by j omega plus e power minus 3t into u of t. So this is the answer for this simple problem using partial fraction method. So this is the answer you have to write. So let us see this in the same model. Let us see the second question. Let us see the second question very another same method. Just values are different. What is x of omega? X of omega is given as 4 into j omega plus 6 by, so j omega whole square plus 6 into j omega plus 8. So what we can do is that, just to separate, so 4 into j omega plus 6 by separate as fraction the denominator. I can write it as j omega plus 2 into j omega plus 4. J omega plus 4. So write it as a by partial fraction is a by j omega plus 2 plus b by j omega plus 4. So how to calculate a? So what is the denominator of a? Just multiply with that. So it will become 4 into j omega plus 6 by so j omega plus 4. Substitute in place of j omega minus 2. So if you substitute minus 2 here, so minus 8 plus 6 will become minus 2 by 4 minus 2, it will become 2. So the answer is minus 1. So let us calculate b. So just multiply with the denominator of b. So it will become 4 into j omega plus 6 by so j omega plus 2. Substitute j omega is equal to minus 4 in the problem. So minus 16 plus 6, it will become minus 10 by minus 4 plus 2, it will become minus 2, it will become 5. So therefore x of omega can be written as a. What is the value of a? A is minus 1. Minus 1 by j omega plus 2 plus what is b? 5 by j omega plus 4. So taking inverse Fourier transform on both sides, so it will become, write it as x of t, so that is equal to minus 1 or minus into e power minus 2t into u of t plus 5 into e power minus 4t into u of t. So this is the answer for this problem. Now let us see the next problems. Let us see the third problem on partial fraction method. X of omega is equal to what is given? 1 plus 3 into j omega by j omega plus 3 whole square. So let us see how to do this. So therefore what we can write it as solution. So x of omega, so what is given? 1 plus 3 into j omega by so j omega plus 3 whole square, which can be written as a by partial fraction method, as you know that how to write a by 3 plus j omega plus b by j omega plus 3 whole square. So write like this. So now, so first in this method, shortcut method, first to find out the value of b. Remember that, first to find out the value of b. So what is the denominator of b? Just multiply with j omega plus 3 whole square. So therefore it will become b. So you can slightly calculate b. So just multiply denominator gets cancelled out. 3 into j omega. Substitute just j omega is equal to minus 3. What is j omega is equal to minus 3? So j omega is equal to minus 3. So 1 minus 9, it will become minus 8. So this is the first. You can easily calculate b by using shortcut method, remember. So a, in finding out a also, if you just multiply j omega plus 3, the denominator 1 j omega plus 3 will remain. If you substitute j omega is equal to minus 3, the entire term will become infinity. So therefore in finding a also, just multiply it with the highest power. So that means j omega plus 3 whole square. So but what we have to do is that 1 by j we have to multiply, remember that, d by d omega. So what is the less 2 minus 1? 1. So the power is 1. So therefore differentiate one time, the 1 plus j 3 omega, and in the substitute in the answer j omega is equal to minus 3. So this is the shortcut you have to remember. So 1 by j. So what is the d by d omega of j 3 omega? It is 3j. So there is no omega to substitute. It will come out as jj gets cancels out. It will come out as 3. So therefore, what is x of omega? So therefore, x of omega is equal to what is a? A is 3 by j omega plus 3. So what is b? So b is minus 8 by j omega plus 3 whole square. If you take the inverse Fourier transform on both sides, x of t is equal to 3 into e power minus 3t into u of t. So minus f square is there, I have given the formula. 8 into t into e power minus 3t into u of t. So 1 by j omega plus a whole square is t into e power minus a t into u of t, which I have given the formula in the starting of the problem. So therefore, this is the answer for this problem. In the similar way, you can do the fourth problem also. So this is about finding the inverse Fourier transform of given problems by using partial fraction method. Thank you.